the music that's currently on right now. We've got on the Schlitz stage Lou Nasa, Marianne Miller's over at the Harp stage, Channel 6. We've got Fiddler's Green from Chicago over at Miller and Pabst. We've got the Gary Irish Dancers. Tonight we'll have Carmel Quinn again, John Gary and Joe Feeney, and then later on Blarney. We'll have De Dunnan and we'll have the Red Clay Ramblers. So all in all, we're in for a real exciting day, and we're looking up here right now at all the people on the bridge who are trying to get down here and join us at Irish Fest, and it's going to be a great day.
And basically what we have here is old forms of music, song and dance, which have been preserved here in America by the musicians. Older musicians and now younger musicians, some of them indeed with no Irish-American ancestry at all. I find a lot of people from different ethnic groups have been drawn to Irish music, mostly to the folk revival, but sometimes by hearing Irish groups playing in festivals and concerts, the kind of festivals we have here. And the idea of the workshops, again, is to explore somewhat more in depth the background, the history of the songs, various styles of playing, say, on the different instruments, and there's so many different instruments in the Irish tradition, the fiddle, the flute, the concertina, accordion, pipes, whistle, guitar, banjo, mandolin, and so on, that an awful lot of people really are very interested in finding out the background to how Irish music got to be played on these instruments and the various regional styles, and in some cases the American styles, because Irish communities here, because they were cut off from Ireland, sometimes evolved different ways of interpreting the older forms of music and song than the people back home in Ireland. The Greenfields of America was conceived really to bring the older forms of Irish traditional music, song and dance to Irish communities across America that hadn't been perhaps as much in touch with this aspect of Irish American culture as they might have liked to have been, because some of the older musicians died off. And before the, say, 1970s, when there was a resurgence of interest in ethnicity and roots, there wasn't a great deal of interest, frankly, in many Irish communities in the older forms. But things have really switched around now, and I think the Greenfields of America has been partly responsible in certain areas for restoring an interest in the older forms of Irish culture, and also in encouraging younger people who are Irish American to take pride in their cultural heritage, to learn the older forms which have been around for several hundreds of years, and it would be a great pity to see them die out. And that's what we're all about, trying to keep it going.
You know? Thank you.
Dutchman's not the kind of man to keep his thumb jammed in the dam that holds his dreams in. But that's a secret only Margaret knows. When Amsterdam is golden in the morning, Margaret brings him breakfast. She believes him. He thinks the tulips bloom beneath the snows. He's mad as he can be, but Margaret only sees that sometimes. Sometimes she sees her unborn children in his eyes. Let us go to the banks of the ocean, where the walls rise above the Zuider Zee. Long ago, I used to be a young man, and dear Margaret remembers that for me. The Dutchman still wears wooden shoes, his cap and coat are patched with love that Margaret sewed in. Sometimes he thinks he's still in Rotterdam. He watches tugboats down canals and calls out to them when he thinks he knows the captain. Till Margaret comes to take him home again, through unforgiving streets that trip him though she holds his arm. Sometimes he thinks that he's alone and he calls her name. Oh, let us go to the banks of the ocean, where the walls rise above the Zaire Sea. Long ago, I used to be a young man, and dear Margaret remembers that for me. The windmills swirl the winter in, she winds his muffler tighter. They sit in the kitchen, and the tea with whiskey keeps away the dew. He sees her for a moment, calls her name, she makes his bed up, humming some old love song. She learned it when the tune was very new. He hums a line or two, they hum together in the night. The Dutchman falls asleep and Margaret blows the candle out. Oh, let us go to the banks of the ocean, where the walls rise above the Zuider Zee. Can't hear you. Long ago, I used to be a young man, and dear Margaret, sing it out with us once. Let us go to the banks of the ocean, where the walls rise above the Zuider Zee. Long ago, I used to be a young man, and dear Margaret remembers that for me.
Tommy Makem and Patty Clancy and his brothers started singing at the Cherry Lane Theater in New York with people like Woody Guthrie and Gene Ritchie, Bob Dylan. And they kind of set a trend at the time because they were singing songs of their own heritage and kind of were a lesson to other American folk singers to delve back into their own heritage and history.
A gypsy rover come over the hill, down through the valley so shady. He whistled and he sang till the green woods rang, and he won the heart of a lady. Ah-dee-doo, ah-dee-doo, da-dee. Ah-dee-doo, ah-dee-dee. He whistled and he sang till the green woods rang.
Yes!
Castle gate, she left her own fond lover, she left her servants and estate to follow the gypsy rover. And again, a-dee-doo, a-dee-doo, da-dee, a-dee-doo, a-dee-dee-dee. He whistled and he sang till the green woods rang. Saddled up his fastest steed, roamed the valleys all over, sought his daughter at great speed, and the whistling gypsy rover. Ah-dee-doo, ah-dee-doo, da-dee, ah-dee-doo, ah-dee-dee.
sang till the greenwoods rang. He came at last to a mansion fine, down valley so shady, and there was music and there was wine for the gypsy and his lady. You're on your own, the whole thing. The job, he is no gypsy, my father, she said, but lord of these lands all over, and I will stay till my dying day on my whistling gypsy roll. Last chance, adi-do, adi-do, da-day, adi-do, adi-day. And he sang till the green woods rang, and he won the heart of the lady.
I would say Irish music is at the heart of our culture. The music is an extension of the culture we've come from, and we need to keep that and celebrate that as much as we can. So.
Red is the rose that in yonder garden grows. Fair is the lily of the valley.
Here is the water. Flows from the boyne, but my love is fairer than any. Was down by Killarney's green woods that we strayed when the moon and the stars, they were shining. The moon shone its rays on her locks of golden hair. She swore she'd be my love forever. And red is the rose, and red is the rose that in yonder garden grows. Fair as a lily, fair is the lily. Clear is the water, clear is the water that flows from the boyne, but my love is fairer. Not for the parting with my sister Kate, it's not for the grief of my mother, it's all for the loss of my bonny Irish lass, that my heart is breaking forever. Sing it yourselves, red is the rose, red.
Scottish friends, you'll take the high road and I'll take the low, and I'll be in Scotland before you. For me and my true love will never meet again on the bonny, bonny banks of Loch Lomond. And red is the rose that in yonder garden blows. Fair is the lily of the valley. Clear is the water that flows from the point. My love is fairer than any.
By a lonely prison wall, I heard a young girl calling. Michael, they've taken you away. Before you stole Trevelyan's corn, so the young might see the morn, as the prison ship lies waiting in the bay. Let's see.
Low lie the fields of Athenry, where once we watched the small free birds fly. Our love was on the wing, we had dreams and songs to sing. It's so lonely round the fields of Athenry. I heard a young man calling. Nothing matters, Mary, when you're free. Against the famine and the crown, I rebelled, they put me down. Now you must raise our child with dignity.
Here we go.
Though lie the fields of Athenry, where once we watched the small free birds fly. Our love was on the wing, we had dreams and songs to sing. It's so lonely round the fields of Athenry.
By a lonely harbor wall, she watched the last star fall. As the prison ship sailed out against the sky,
for she lives to hope and pray for her love in Botany Bay. So lonely round the fields of Athenry.
Up your voices, here we go.
Low-lying the fields of Athenry, where once we watched the small free birds fly.
sing. It's so lonely round the fields of Bath and Rye. No lie, the fields of Bath and Rye, where once we watched the small free birds fly. Our love was on the wing. We had dreams and songs to sing. So lonely round the fields of Bath and Rye. It's so lonely round the fields. Let's hear of beautiful. Nice one, thanks.